Yeah, the main thing with our guys in terms of preparation is we're going to see a little bit bigger golf course this week, only two par fives. They do have a couple of drivable par fours. So as we've prepared and we've played, some rounds back in Charlotte to get ready for this week, we've kind of set golf courses up that way to hopefully prepare the guys for what we're going to see. It's a terrific golf course, great par threes, but a fun golf course to play. Birdies are out there, but you have to play well to get them, that's for sure. Well, once again, and Jerry always does a great job with invitations and being able to pull in some great teams. Auburn and Alabama right off the top, both Final Four teams last year. Alabama played for national championship, and they're both really, really good again this year. Arkansas will be there as well. So we're going to see, some fantastic nationally ranked, very competitive at a national level teams this week, and we'll have our work cut out for us. The biggest thing for us is going to be consistency. If you look back at Minnesota, we just had a rough day that first 36 holes, and we had some young guys in the lineup. So, you kind of get a free pass there. We played fantastic in the final round there. Louisville and River Run, last week in Davidson, we're still looking for consistency from top to bottom in the lineup. We look at, Louisville, Carson shoots 65 in the first round. And then we end up having to count, I think we get to seven under through three guys. We end up having to count an eight over in that round. Same thing with last week at River Run. We get to I guess it was 10 under through three guys and have to count five over. So although we were leading, after that round, it could have been a larger margin had we had more consistency throughout the lineup. So the key for this team moving forward is going to be, can we get consistent contributions one through five? And there are a couple different factors with that we have talked about with the guys and things that we have to address. Our misses have to be smaller. We got to keep the ball in play more often. And when we are a little bit out of position, making sure that we minimize damage in that standpoint. Bogeys are not going to hurt us, but we're counting way too many big numbers, too many double bogeys, that once we kind of clean those things up, now all of a sudden I think we start seeing more progress in terms of results. And I don't like to get result-oriented, but at the same time, we've got to play better and perform better than what we have up to this point. So those will be some things that we'll continue, hopefully, to get better on this week in Birmingham and continue to do so throughout the season. Well, it gives us a measuring stick as to where we are in relation to the best teams in the country, because ultimately that should be our goal here and something that we strive for every day to compete not only for an NCAA regional berth, but an NCAA finals berth. And in doing so, we need to know where we stack up in relation to the best teams in the country. So this gives us an opportunity to do that. You look at that Arkansas team, we saw them in Minnesota a few weeks ago. So now we're gonna get a pretty good judge of where were we compared to them the first week in September versus where are we the first week in October. And we'll see if we've made progress or if they've made more progress than we have. But ultimately that's our scheduling, thought and idea is to compete against the best teams so that we know where we stack up with those best teams in the country. And sometimes you find that, okay, we're in a pretty good spot. Sometimes you find that we have a little ways to go. I feel like another great opportunity this week to find out where we stack up and how much more progress we need to make to catch up with some of those guys.